Well, hello.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Hi. We haven't seen each other much in the last
20 years.
I've heard, this is the first time you've actually seen each other in 20 years.
We've seen each other a couple times.
Yeah,
and we saw each other yesterday in and out of the gym.
Right.
I was going in and he was going out. So that was great.
Such a pleasure to have you here in Australia. Is this a first visit for either of you?
No, I was here maybe 9 or 10 years ago and had a great time then.
Excellent.
And I was here maybe 22
years ago,
back when I was 11. It was great.
Is there one thing about Sydney that you're enjoying so far?
Well, I say I loved Australia when I was here the first time. Mm-hmm. And the reason I loved Australia, it's beautiful, it's great, it's got a lot of wonderful land and stuff, but the people are fantastic, and I love being down here, and thank you for having us. It's great.
Excellent. Now, it has been a while since we've seen The Adventures of Lois and Clark. Do you guys have a fond memory from working on that show together?
Oh, absolutely not. No, not one. Not one. We have a whole bunch of fond memories.
Yeah.
Tons and tons. You want to hear a story? What do you want to hear?
Yeah, yeah. Do you have one that, like, sticks out the most?
One story that's... None that sticks out the most.
I just like the... I just think my favorite episode, which... Well, okay, now that I'm thinking... No, like, the pilot... My favorite episode, I was going to say, is the one, the honeymoon one, where we stayed from the first season, where we stayed in the hotel... Do you remember that one?
I do.
Does anybody remember that one?
Yes.
Yeah, I think that was one of my favorite ones. I don't know why. I mean, I do know why, but anyway, I love the banter that we had. Jeez, I'm doing good here.
You're doing great. Good. My favorite.
But the pilot. No, I just remember. I really do remember vividly when you flew me in through the window of the Daily Planet
with no wires.
With no wires.
I actually flew in.
That's how good he is. Yeah, that was that moment has never gone away. Like, that was just so, you just knew that was special. Yeah.
That was a very cool moment. A lot of people flying us, but that was a good moment. It became an iconic shot coming through the Daily Planet windows. My favorite moment in the whole series, though, I think was when Clark is proposing to Lois, and Lois asks, who's asking, Clark or Superman? I just think it's romantic. I thought it was great. It's my favorite moment.
Was it enjoyable bringing that sort of characteristics to Superman when he's more commonly been known as a character that's a bit stuffy, like Clark Kent's a bumbling, you know.
Well,
don't want to say moron, but
you can call him a moron because that wasn't my character. Christopher Reeve, in his incarnation, what they were doing, it was very clear to make Clark a bumbling guy, and the whole thing about, you know, wearing the glasses, not wearing the glasses, and that's the disguise. You have to buy into that. Although we had some villains say to her, duh, you know, that was the moment. But it was, we did something different. The way it was created, Deborah Joy Levine, when she wrote it on the paper, it was Lois and Clark, The New Adventures of Superman. So it's about those two and the relationship. And what was so great about it for Clark was that's the character. Clark is the guy, and then he became Superman in disguise. In order to keep his anonymity. And that was a different take. And I think they did a great job with doing that. And the thing I loved about our show that doesn't sort of exist in the current incarnation, not that I'm bashing it, but it's just different, is we had, there was comedy and there was romance.
Exactly.
And there isn't much of that in the Batman versus Superman. Not that they should have a romance, because I don't think they should, but it's a different world.
And there was a real emphasis on Lois for, I think, the first time ever in the story.
Mm-hmm.
And her sort of growth, you know, and discovery and balance between being a working woman and also trying to find room and let herself feel vulnerable and in love. And those are things that we love to see in our female characters. And I think that was the first time that was really brought to the forefront.
Yeah, I mean, Lois has always been quite a tough nut character. To see her softer side and her romance develop between superhero characters was probably pretty new at the time.
And also just not being second fiddle to Clark or Superman. You know, it was really all... It was a three-character show, right?
No question about it. And I also loved that it